Moriah is a full-time working mom with an unusual hobby. She runs 100-mile races. As if that isn't hard enough, Moriah was born with severe scoliosis. Look at her spine. A year ago, she finally had surgery, and she's already back on the trail. So what's it like to run 100 miles?
In the beginning, you're thinking, this is great. I can't wait. This is so exciting. In the middle, you're like, what did I sign up for? Oh my gosh. Towards the end, that voice in your head, can't do it. No way. Mm-mm. The minute you cross that finish line, you're like, I knew I could do it. I knew it. I can't wait to do it again.
But it turns out there's a lot more to long distance running than just putting in the miles.
You don't just show up and run 100 miles. You plan. What am I going to tell myself at mile 50 when my brain is saying, you need to stop?
What do you say?
You're stronger than you think. You can do hard things. You didn't get up at 4 a.m. to run 20 miles before work to quit at mile 50.
Long distance running also teaches you to expect the unexpected.
The thing about running 100 miles is nothing goes as planned, nothing is consistent.
But if you don't give up, the payoff is huge.
Do you remember when you were little and someone would say to you, you can do anything, just put your mind to it? Most people don't ever really put that to the challenge. After you realize you can run distance, you can do anything. Anything is possible. Anything. Anything.
But for Moriah, it was so much more than that.
I went into running broken, physically and mentally. And I came out of running whole.
That had a lot to do with the friends she met along the way.
When I started, I didn't know if I would be accepted. And then I found these amazing people that didn't even give it a thought and just said, come join us, come with us. Will you come back next week? We're running on Thursday, will you join us? It's so nice out, isn't it? And the more I ran, the more contagious the energy, the smiles, the questions.
Who found that out first?
George did.
Is it you're sleeping with that?
No!
Asking me how I'm doing.
He was fantastic. I was so surprised. And he wasn't even getting any treats.
It didn't happen overnight, and it didn't happen in a week or a year. But the more I showed up, the more I felt whole. I do want to make clear that most often when we show up, we're actually thinking what we can eat after. We love food, which is a very wonderful thing about trail running. There is always food.
Yeah, the little sea salt on it.
Until she's cleared to race again, Moriah supports other runners at long distance events.
Yeah, you got it. You need anything else?
I'm good, thank
all right,
you.
Nice job, buddy. What do you need?
I love meeting new people.
Is this fine? Do you want salt tabs? Or?
I love smiling at someone that doesn't expect it.
I know, it's so great. You're doing fantastic. Nice job.
Oh, no, my God, they're the best.
Kindly.
You're welcome. Great job.
When I ask someone a question, I'm asking because I want to know.
And who else is running?
My husband, Kendall. We live in Virginia.
Okay.
I want to know what's your daughter's name.
Really? You are so tough. Can I have a high five for being tough?
Who's here at the race running? Who is your dad?
Are you her dad or her?
Yeah, that's where Ray is.
Oh!
When he comes through the aid station, I want to cheer for him.
Olivia!
Why would I walk by you and not say hello?
Do you guys want a bell? We have two. When you see a runner go by, you bring that.
Why would I walk by you and not smile? Notice your dog.
What are your dog's names?
This one's Leo. This is Raya's dog.
Notice your little kid. Why would I not engage?
Oh, come pet Leo. This is Leo. What is your name?
I think everyone struggles.
There you go.
And everybody wants to feel connected on a human level. That's one of the things I'm teaching Kate. How to communicate, how to engage.
Nice job.
Does that mean Kate has to run too?
She never even has to run 5 miles or a mile. I would like Kate to find what she likes to do. If she wants to play softball and that's her thing, we focus on that. If Kate wants to cultivate her love of art, then we do that. If I want Kate to be strong and confident, honestly, it starts with me. I have to be strong and confident. I have to show her what that looks like. I want to raise a happy, confident, kind, empathetic child.
Luckily, Moriah has lots of help.
Best thing about my family is we love each other unconditionally and always show up. When you see the happiness, the joy, human touch, a hug, maybe nobody even hugged you all day. Maybe no one smiled at you. You see it, you feel it, you're included. Doesn't matter how you show up. Whether you show up at dinner and you don't really know if you want to be there because you have so much work to do, just show up. Energy, positive energy, is contagious. It surrounds you. It is absolutely 100% really hard not to smile when someone is smiling, looking at you, hugging you, laughing with you. How could you not smile? At the core, being happy with who you are is where it starts. I was not always happy with who I was. It took me a long time to find my people, to surround myself with things that I enjoy, that I love. The key to happiness, I think, starts with me and being okay with who I am.